The next type of your nested classes is static nested class. So let us see what are static nested class. A static nested class is nothing but a static member of your outer class. See, in an outer class you may have static members, right? So when you create an inner class as static, that class becomes as a static member to your outer class. Similarly, for static members, how do you do? How do you call them? You do not have to instantiate your outer class. Similarly, in this case, you will not have to instantiate your outer class to call the static member of your outer class. That is nothing but to call your nested inner class, which is static nested inner class. The another property of static members is nothing but it will not be able to access the instance variable. Similarly, in the static nested classes can also not access the instance variable of your outer class. So what is the syntax of it? You write class, the outer class name, in the braces you write your inner class, where the inner class will be having a static keyword. So let us run a program to understand in detail how a static inner class works. So you write outer class, public class, outer class name. In that we create an inner class which is of static. It can be private and then it is static. Static class and then the class name. So this nested class is your static inner class. And what is this static inner class doing? It is writing a method to display a statement calling this is a static nested class. So we have created a method called display under your inner class. And now this inner class method, how will it be called or how this will be instantiated? We need to see that. So under your outer class, you write static void main string args. You need to first instantiate your outer class with your inner class. In cases of your previous non-static inner classes or inner classes, method local inner class and anonymous, you were instantiating your inner classes separately. But in case of your static inner classes, you need to instantiate the object of static inner class along with your outer class. So you write outer class dot inner class, then the object name equals to new outer class dot your inner class. Again repeating, you need to write outer class dot inner class, create or write a object name that you would want equals to new outer class dot inner class and then the bracket. And then how would you call the method of your inner class? It's nothing but with the help of this object that you have created. The object that you have created is as nested. So you write nested dot display method, and this display method is under your nothing but inner class. So an static inner class is nothing but acts as a static member of your outer class. When you had to call a static member, you would have directly called without instantiating it. But in order to call a static nested inner class, what you do is that first you write the outer class dot inner class, instantiate an object, and then equals to new outer class dot inner class, and with the help of that object you call the methods of your static inner classes. So let us run this program practically to understand how does a static inner class works. This is an example to understand about the static nested classes. By now we have understood what are the non-static nested classes, how do we declare them, and where do we instantiate each of them. So let us now see an example for static nested classes. Static nested classes are nothing but behaves as a static member for that particular class. How would you declare a static member? With the help of static keyword. Similarly, a static class would be written with the help of a keyword called static. So let us see how do we write. We have created a class called static nested classes, which is an outer class, and inside that we declare our inner class. Normally, how do you declare inner classes? Outside you declare an outer class, inside that immediately you declare an inner class. Once you declare your inner class with the keyword called static, it becomes static nested class. But how you would instantiate a static nested class is different from your non-static inner class. So here we have declared our static nested class as private. So you write access modifier, the static keyword, class keyword, followed with your inner class name,
and our inner class name is nested class. In the brackets, we have created one method which is displaying that this is an example of static nested class. Once you create that method, you need to close the braces and then close the your nested class, which is your static nested class. And where would you instantiate this static nested class is inside the main method of your outer class. So in the main method, you instantiate your outer plus inner class together. How would you do that? You write your outer class name dot inner class name, then the object name equals to new outer class name dot inner class. Again repeating, how do you instantiate your inner class is that you instantiate with your outside class, which is nothing but your inner class is static and your outer class consists of your main method again, which is static. So to declare a static variable or to instantiate a static static member, you need to instantiate with your outer class. So you write the outer class dot inner class, the object name equals to new outer class dot inner class, open and close brackets, and then semicolon. And with the help of this object that you have created, you will call the method of your static class. Because your class is of a static type, you are able to call a method which is lying under static. A non-static will not be called like this. So let us save and execute this file. So in the console, as you can see, it says this is an example of a static nested class. So this is how you create your static nested classes.